Hello everyone, I'm Pastor Rex and welcome to Mosaic Church of the Nazarene. Today, Pastor Jeff will be sharing from the Word of God titled, How to Receive the Blessings of the Lord. But first, please join us in some praise and worship to glorify the Lord.
Hallelujah, I want to sing all about it. Hallelujah, I want to shout all about it. Hallelujah, I can't be without it. Praise God, praise God. Now I'm living in a new creation. Now it's bringing from the well of salvation. Now there's no condemnation.
Hallelujah, I want to sing all about it. Hallelujah, I want to shout all about it. Hallelujah, I can't live without it. Praise God, praise God. But now I'm living in a new creation. Now I'm drinking from the well of salvation. Now there is no condemnation. Praise God. Hallelujah, I want to sing all about it. Hallelujah, I want to shout all about it. Hallelujah, I can't live without it. Praise God, praise God. Now I'm living in a new creation. Now I'm drinking from the well of salvation. Now there is no condemnation. Praise God.
Welcome, Mosaic Church of the Nazarene. I'm Pastor Jeff, and have we got a message for you tonight. Tonight's devotional, our midweek devotional titled, How to Receive God's Blessings. We need more blessings. Now, many people talk about feeling or being blessed. I'm blessed. I'm blessed. Describing an experience of gratitude or acceptance of God's gift, or just good general fortune, you know, all the way around. I'm blessed. Everything's going well for the time being. But blessings don't come from luck or chance. Blessings, if we get down to it, are spoken of frequently in the Bible as coming from God as a direct result of our thoughts and our actions. As an example, in the book of Luke, chapter 6, verse 38, it says, "Give, and it will be given to you." Pressed down, shaken together, it goes on. I don't know if it's in that same verse, but give, the whole point, give, and it will be given to you. A blessing, somebody giving to me based on my action of giving to them. The law of reciprocity, reaping and sowing. Some people might want to call it karma, but it really comes from the Lord God Almighty. So, aside from that, how does one get to be blessed? How do we reach that, that blessed state rather than it just being luck or coincidence? What does the Bible say about being blessed? To begin with, we receive God's blessing in this example by realizing that the Lord has blessed us already. In the book of Ephesians, chapter 1, verses 3 and 4, "Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in heavenly realms with every spiritual blessing in Christ. For he chose us in him before the creation of the world to be holy and blameless in his sight." Do you understand what's going on there? God chose us. He was able to see in the future. You know how you have people that are psychics nowadays? Sometimes they're right, sometimes they're horribly wrong. God is never wrong. God is able to see in the future. And it says here that he looked into the future and he chose us before the world, was created, before he even created the world. He looked forward and knew, "You'll be mine, you'll be mine, you'll be mine, you'll be mine," because of the decisions that we made in choosing him. He loved us first, don't get me wrong, but then we choose him. There was a partnership there. So what a blessing to know that we're already blessed because he chose us. If you have accepted the Lord Jesus and you believe in him and you try to do those things that are pleasing to God, your blessings abound already. The opening line reminds us that in reality, we are already blessed. Earth's creation and our redemption is a blessing of the Lord, without whom we would not be here. The blessing of the Lord comes from obedience to God. That's where the real, if we were to wrap it all up in a nutshell, and that's the only thing I would tell you, you want to be blessed? The blessing of the Lord comes from the obedience of God, or the obedience to God and his word and his commandments. Doing the things that God has told you to do. Because God has only told us to do the things that are right and the things that will bless us. He's never told us to do anything that would cause us harm or give us grief. He's only told us to do those things that are a blessing. Let's start in the book of, we're going to do a few scriptures here, but it all comes from the book of Deuteronomy. Back in the Old Testament, back when he was laying out the law, so to speak. In the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verses 1 through 14, it says, if you, there's a condition, you don't just get blessed for the fun of it. It's not, you know, like doing a scratcher. You know what a scratcher is? Those scratch-off lottery tickets. It's not like winning a scratch-off lottery ticket. Oh, 1 out of 5 times I won, therefore I'm blessed. It's not like that. But if you fully obey the Lord your God and carefully follow all of His commandments I give you this day, the Lord your God will set you high above all nations of the earth. Now here he's talking about a people in general. Let's say the United States, if the United States will carefully follow all of God's commandments, He will set us high above all the nations of the earth, which He has at one point in time. I don't know so much anymore, but let's keep going. Now, verse number 2, all these blessings will come upon you and accompany you if you obey the Lord your God. We could keep coming back to that doing what God says business. You will be blessed in the city, you'll be blessed in the country. Where do you live? I live in the country, but I'm only a couple minutes away from the city. So you just got to drive down the road there. So, but no matter what, city or country, I'm blessed. I'm blessed because I obey the Lord. Verse number 4, the fruit of your womb, your children, will be blessed, and the crops of your land, and the young of your livestock, and the calves of your herds, and the lambs of your flocks. This is how people made their livings back in Deuteronomy days, way back thousands of years ago. Pretty much everyone was a farmer, and they raised these animals for their food and for their livelihood. Verse 5, your basket and your kneading trough will be blessed. That's how the bread was made, which, when done properly, was also a blessing of good health. So that was the basket and the kneading trough, because bread was very... How many of you like bread? I'm a big fan of bread. I think Jesus was a fan of bread. They're always breaking it and sharing with others and having a blessing when people gathered together for supper. So good health, a blessing of good health. Verse 6, you'll be blessed when you come in, blessed when you go out, blessed and successful. This is what that means. In all aspects of life, in everything in between, coming in and going out, rising up and laying down, your blessings will be there. These are promises of God way back thousands of years ago. If, again, you commit to doing those things which are good and the things that the Lord has told you. Now, granted, I'll throw a little disclaimer in here for you. You're not going to do everything perfect. You're going to make mistakes. That's okay, because God has grace. That's where grace comes in. He knows you're not perfect. He knows we're going to make a mistake. But if you commit and make a commitment to God, I'm going to do things your way. I'm going to do the best that I can. And please help me when I don't do the things that you want. Please correct me and help me. There you go. You still get these blessings. Verse number 7. The Lord will grant that the enemies who rise up against you, people who talk nasty about you, people that, you know, that are out to get you, the Lord will grant that the enemies who rise up against you will be defeated before you. They will come at you from one direction, but flee in 7. Hallelujah! We don't have to worry about the terror by night. We don't have to worry about that. God has our back because we were faithful to Him. Verse 8, the Lord will send a blessing on your barns and on everything you put your hand to. You know, your grain and stuff like that, all the stuff you store up for the wintertime. Look at the cold temperatures. All the stuff that we used to have to store up for the wintertime, now we go to the grocery store, but some of us still stockpile in case we can't get out of the house. God will, He will bless that. He will send a blessing on your barns and everything. Bless you in the land He is giving you. The Lord will establish you as His holy people, as He promised you on oath, if you keep the commands of the Lord your God and walk with Him in obedience. Verse 10, then all the peoples on the earth, everyone around you, will see that you're called by the name of the Lord. You're called by the name of the Lord, and they will fear you. Don't mess with that guy. Not fear you like, oh, he's a bad dude, get out of his way, he's coming to get you. Not like that. Don't mess with him. This is one of the Lord's people. Don't mess with him. Verse 11, the Lord will grant you abundant prosperity. Sounds like money to me. Now, this isn't the prosperity gospel, but it does say that he will grant you abundant prosperity in the fruit of your womb, the young of your livestock, and the crops of your ground. This in that day, that's what he's talking about. Everything that you set your hand to will prosper. In the land he swore to your ancestors to give you. He was talking with the children of Israel back then. That you'll be in this land and everything you set your hand to, you will prosper it. Verse 12, the Lord will open the heavens, the storehouse of his bounty, to send rain on your land in season and to bless all the work of your hands. You will lend to many nations, but borrow from none. Now, that verse, let's just pause for a moment. You will lend to many nations and will borrow from none. I think there was a time that the United States was like that. Would you consider that we are like that now? Not if you've ever heard of the national debt. Trillions, unfortunately, trillions that we owe others. The United States has kind of went astray a little bit. We've went astray because we're not doing those things that the Lord have said. The Lord has said, that's the things that he's told us plainly and clearly in the Bible, without manipulating it, without saying, well, it means really this, or it depends on which version you're reading as to how you interpret that, or everybody's interpretation of the Bible is different. No. Some things are pretty darn clear. And most all the Bibles, even though there's different versions, different interpretations, they're all kind of saying the same thing, unless you get a really crazy Bible. This is when things go awry. Let me ask you this. The United States, yeah, we're in debt. We're in debt to others. What about you? Are you the lender and the giver? Or are you the borrower and the slave to the lender? How do you fall into that? If you fall into that, now I know there's times that hard times can befall us all, sometimes as a lesson from the Lord. But as a whole, where do you fall at? Are you the United States? Or are you the other countries that are lending sometimes to the United States? Good thing to think about. Good thing to think about. Verse 13, the Lord will make you the head, not the tail. What about in your job? Are you one of those people that keep rise, no matter what you do, you keep rising up the ladder of success? The Lord will make you the head and not the tail. If you pay attention to the commands of your Lord, of the Lord your God, that I give you this day and follow them carefully, you will always be at the top and never the bottom. Amen. Always be at the top. How would that feel? Maybe you're there. Maybe you're always, you know, oh, granted, maybe you're not the CEO, but you're at the top of the ladder, right underneath the CEO. That's pretty much the top. You know, if you figure there are 18 rungs on the ladder, I'm thinking that the top five rungs, that's pretty much the top. Then you got the middle rungs, and then you got the lower rungs. Where are you at in your life, in your career, with your family, with your community, the people that surround you? Are you at the top? The Lord had promised you. He promised you that you would always be at the top if you follow his commandments. Do not turn aside from any of the commands I give you this day, to the right or to the left, following other gods or serving them. Be careful. Be careful. that you don't let other things take place of your relationship with the Lord. That's serving other gods. Putting money ahead of the Lord. Serving other gods. Bible, you know, it's probably said you can't serve mammon and God, money. You can't serve money and God. It's got to be one or the other. Don't put other gods before our God. Don't let things take place of God. Be careful to do those things with which he said, remember the title, How to Receive the Lord's Blessings. Realize that we're already blessed and do those things that the Lord has told us. In the book of Corinthians, we'll wrap it up with this. In the book of Corinthians, we see that blessings come because of us blessing those around us. 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verses 8 and 9. And God is able to bless you abundantly so that in all things, at all times, having all that you need, you will abound in every good work. As it is written, they have freely scattered their gifts to the poor. Their righteousness endures forever. I hope you're one of those people. Let's pray. Let's pray for you. If you're not, let's pray for you. If you are, Heavenly Father, we come before you. Thank you, Lord God. We just thank you for this message, Lord God, this message on your blessings. We pray that you would help us to be faithful to you. We pray, Lord God, that you would help us to follow and to do those things that you have taught us to do, that you've commanded us to do, and that you have set in place that is the right thing to do, that we would be blessed in our comings and in our goings and everywhere in between. And, Lord God, that we could be a blessing to others. We thank you, Lord God. We give you praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Be blessed.
Down at the cross where my Savior died, down for cleansing from sin I cried. There in my heart was the blood of the Lamb. Glory to his name.
Blood of Christ, glory to his name.
Thank you, Pastor Jeff, and thank you everyone for tuning in into our midweek devotional. If you have been blessed by today's message and you're watching on YouTube, please give us a thumbs up and click on the bell to be notified of our future videos. Please join us at our next service. We welcome you and your entire family. And you'll find us right across from Skateland here on Dorth Highway. It's Sunday morning at 10:30 a.m. We pray that the Lord may bless you so that you then may become a blessing to others.